So good morning, Michael. And good morning, Michael. What a tremendous pleasure to have you two Michaels here joining me this morning for this conversation. As you know, the first edition for our series of important, you know, partner keynote dialogues to the Bechtle Competence Day in 2020. And it's obviously a great pleasure to start this series of conversations with you guys this morning. And, you know, before we start, I have to say that we have three Michaels in the room here. So to the audience out there, it might get a little confusing because whenever I say Michael, 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 then you might never know who I actually speak to. But, you know, we'll find our way. And I think that this is a great opportunity for us three Michaels to prove that three Michaels are always better than one Michael. But, you know, enough with the Michaels. Let's start. So Michael G., Michael Guschebauer, you told me in preparation for the conversation we have today that you have prepared a little story, a personal and transformational story you want to share, you want to share with us. So do you want to go ahead and talk about this?
Yeah, let's do this. Michael, when we saw us in person last time, it was the end of last year, I think so. We talk about a whole things, but also over polar watches. Do you remember these type of devices?
I do.
This was fancy in the 80s. And this was, from my point of view, I think that was the first fitness trackers overall. And we grew up with these devices as we were young, strong, and fast. And over the days, technique evolved. We talk about last time that you show me the future of these type of devices. What can we do with these things today, and what will be in the future? Would you please share it with our audience today?
Sure. Well, first of all, great to be with you, and super appreciative of the fantastic partnership that we've had for many years with Bechtle, and it's an honor to be with you. But yes, the technology continues to evolve, and you know what I'm using right now is the Oura Ring, which hopefully you can see that, and it's quite small. And actually, the guys in Finland that created the Oura Ring, many of them came from Polar, and so you kind of see the evolution from the watch. And you know the Bluetooth accessory that Polar provides today to now this ring with incredible accuracy inside the sensors. And what I've learned about health and what I believe is that actually sleep is the most important thing.
Absolutely, I totally agree.
The ring. The Oura Ring is way more accurate, and it's also easy to wear, and it gives you far more information about your health, your respiratory rate, resting heart rate, temperature, and it gives you data, right, and information, and it gives you both the near-term view and the long-term view of action and reaction. How do specific activities or things I consume or don't consume affect my sleep and my overall well-being. So I think that's incredibly exciting, and I love it.
Absolutely, and it's a great transformative story, I would say. You know, from these, you know, retro track that we saw in the beginning with these old Polar watches to what we have today. And you know, it simply says a story that, you know, technology gets really close to you. You know, it can't really get much closer to you than as a ring on your finger, I would say. So it creates, you know, not only an interesting, you know, story about new technology, it is also purposeful technology. It really makes sense, and it can enhance the quality of life for many people that are using it. So I think it's a great story. And when we talk about transformation and invention and reinvention, then this is a perfect springboard for me for my next question, Michael, I wanted to address to you. You know, you do not only created Dell, as a company. You reinvented Dell Technologies several times over the course of your impressive career. And obviously, you know, with this, you shaped the industry. And this is why we want to, you know, carefully listen to you and to your predictions for what will be the next stage of our industry. So what is going to happen with this industry over the next 5 to 10 years? What are your expectations?
Well, you know, I think the industry is at a very exciting point. And actually the last 6 months, I think will prove to be a great acceleration of the fourth industrial revolution. And what you have happening right now is an explosion in intelligent and connected things. And so we're going from the age where, you know, it was sort of people talking to computers, computers talking to computers, and everything becoming intelligent. That creates an enormous amount of data. We have artificial intelligence and machine learning, because humans can't possibly interpret all this data, but AI is fantastic at being able to do that. And of course, the challenge for all businesses is to reimagine themselves in the age of all of these amazing technologies, including 5G, which will accelerate everything. And how can you create a better product, a better service, a better outcome for your customer, your student, your patient, whoever it is you're serving, using all of this data, and build competitive advantage? And I think we've seen also in the last 6 months that the digitally enabled businesses have done much better. And I expect all the technologies that we talk about all the time, you know, multi-cloud, the edge, the data management, the software defining of the networks and the creation of 5G, the machine learning and AI, and it will be the big drivers over the next several years. And of course, we also must secure all of this, because as we make everything connected and intelligent, it has to be secure.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And, listening to you, Michael, you know, a lot of what you're saying is about things are getting faster. And you explained it so well that over the past 6 months, we have seen an acceleration, an unprecedented acceleration in so many things. And at the same time, I think it is very important for an organization to have a long-term vision and a long-term goal. And this is why I wanted to ask you about your moonshot goals. I learned about that. Your company, you know, works towards these moonshot goals for 2030. And I think it's important for us and interesting for us to understand what these moonshot goals are. What do you plan for this long period?
So it's not a new thing for us to set goals like this. We did it about 10 years ago with our 2020 goals, and we achieved the vast majority of them. And it's important to say, when we set these goals, you know, 10 years is a long time, we don't actually know how to do all these things. They're aspirational goals, and they stretch us and cause us to use our most creative energies to go solve big problems and big opportunities. So we have set out for 2030 to focus on advancing sustainability, which, for example, includes one-to-one reuse and recycling. So for every product we sell, we will take one back. It focuses on cultivating inclusion and diversity. So, for example, our goal is 50-50 gender representation inside our company. We also focus on transforming a billion lives with our technology and ensuring that we uphold ethics and privacy for our customers and for their data, giving customers control of their data and ensuring that it's protected and secure.
Okay, thank you very much for sharing this, and I think these goals are truly inspirational. I wanted to ask Michael, the other Michael here in the studio, Michael, how does this resonate, this set of goals? How do these goals resonate with your vision for Bechtle for 2030 that you outlined together with your team?
Yeah, I think it resonates our Vision 2030 very well. Yeah. So we made a couple of statements in our Vision 2030. So we have the same rhythm than Dell had. So we had our Vision 2020, and we reached all of the goals 1 year in front of 2020. Yeah. And we have stated our Vision 2030 and make a couple of statements in there. And first of all, we want to empower business. We want to empower business with our customers. We want to be relevant for our customers. So we want to be relevant for our customers' success to provide our solutions, our IT knowledge and our IT advice for the best solutions of our customers to integrate this in their products and services. And we want to be a great place for people who want to accomplish more and great things. And Bechtle will be the place for these kind of people and to work and to live in. And our last goal is we want to double our business, to reach 10 billion euros in 2030 in a profitable way, to create our own future in a very sustainable way. So I think, as I mentioned before, your Moonshot Goals 2030 helps us to reach our Vision 2030 in a very good way, and it resonates very well.
That's good to know, because your partnership, I think, is so important for both organizations. So let's spend a minute or two in our conversation to just talk about this partnership, and I want to learn from both of you. So what are your plans for this partnership? So how do you plan to develop this unique composition of strength and capacities that Dell Technologies and Bechtle bring to the market and help customers to be more successful with that? Maybe, Michael, would you like to start? You, Michael.
So first of all, we want to work together very closely to really be best in class in serving our customers in an impeccable way. And we want to continue to extend the impressive, exclusive partnership that we have with Bechtle. And, we're very focused on bringing the comprehensive portfolio of solutions that we have together to help customers with modernizing their infrastructure, creating the multi-cloud future of the future, enabling their workforce. And I think we're seeing much, much more build out of now the secure distributed workforce, ensuring that they can secure and analyze and create value from all their data and bring it all together in one place and make it easy so that the customers can create the great outcomes that they want to in inside their businesses. That's what we'd like to do together.
Thank you, Michael.
Yeah, that fits nearly perfect to our plans. So as a part of the implementation of our strategy, we take a very huge focus on providing consultants and business architects to the market and to our customers to understand the business of our customers better, in order to give the right advice, to think in use cases, to help them making their business better with our solutions and our portfolio. And when we reach these goals, when we understand our customers better, we can provide the right IT solutions, the right services to make their business better and to integrate these solutions into their products and services to at the end of the show, to make our customers more successful with both our technologies and our services when we provide it in the right way in the market. So it fits perfect.
Not a surprise that this is a great fit and good to hear and truly impressive. Not only that you share these visions and that you thrive to create the commercial success for both of your organizations and also for your customers, but also to understand that these visions are broader and include so important things like, you know, inclusion and diversity, or sustainability and ethics and security. And I think these are so important elements that, you know, these unprecedented times that we are in are making very clear that a vision that really brings us forward needs to include these elements. And it's really impressive to listen to both of you and learn about this. This is great. You know, I want to, we need to come to an end. I don't want to, but we need to come to an end. You know, I want to thank you both for taking the time today. Michael, Dell, to you in particular for taking the time to dial in and be with us and spend some minutes with us. We really appreciate that a lot. And ultimately, I would like to say that, you know, hopefully we see you here in Germany very, very soon again. We know that you like to travel to Germany. So hopefully we meet in person again very, very soon. So thank you very much for taking the time today.
It's an honor and a privilege. And I look forward to being back in Germany soon when we can all travel again. But for now, we're traveling on Teams Airlines, and it's working pretty well.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Have a great day. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Michael. And we are looking forward to see you in person now. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.